At this time, we are going to ask all the ushers and all the visiting ushers to come to the front and take the front seat. We will now have a selection by the ushers.
Whip and scold, but there is nothing mother has from her child. she will withhold. Others may treat you nice, be your sister or your brother, but there is no one in this world to equal a kind and loving you.
At this time, we will have an instrumental solo by Sister Susan Robinson.
Thanks to your chief and her staff for assisting us in the time of our needs at the Faith Baptist Church. When the phone call was made to her to ask, could she come and help us out, she wasn't reluctant to do so. And we wish to thank her and her staff that accompanied her for helping us in the time of our needs. My subject that I've chosen for today is 6 qualifications of an usher. The first is Christianity. To be a good usher, you must be a Christian. A Christian is one who professes Jesus Christ as Savior and accept Him as His Lord. The usher holds an exalted position in the church, yet some of the Christian ushers are not fulfilling their position as God would have them. Some Christians think that they have a hard road to travel. Yet our Savior tells us, for my yoke is easy, my burden is light. Matthew, the 11th chapter, the 30th verse. Second, courtesy. The one outstanding duty of an usher is to be courteous. That is the watchword of all services. If we fail to be courteous to all of the guests, especially the poor, the lame, the blind, we have failed Christ just as much. But if you keep in mind the 5th chapter of Matthew and the 16th verse, which reads, "Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good work, glorify your Father which is in heaven."
Amen.
Alertness. The word alert means to always be on the watch, quick to act. To be a good usher, you must be on the lookout for the crippled, sick, Amen. Fires, or any necessary urgency that may arise. You should be alert to keep down evil or confusion you may sense arising. Be on the alert for necessary or urgent calls or anything the pastor may need you for. It takes all these things to be an alert usher. Promptness. Promptness means to be quick to act as an occasion demands. An usher that is prompt is an asset to his or her leader. He does not have to wonder if the usher will be on time or if he will have enough usher to fill the situation. Courageousness, that's another qualification of an usher. A courageous usher is one who can face life with a smile when they are so or not so pleasant. Can men meet his obligations, sorrows, joys halfway? Usher should work courageously and never doubt himself or herself, but be also ready to give a helping hand when needed. Usher should never become so discouraged that they will leave their task undone because of being criticized or ridiculed. For one to be a courageous usher, one must have faith in God. For only faith in God and in his way of life can give us courage we need to face the test of life. Discipline. The one great factor in success in the usher board of group is discipline, with which it is controlled. Our guidance must come from within, motivated by our love for our work and our love for God. The most successful group of ushers are those that adhere to God's guidance in accepting the position as a doorkeeper in the house of God. This should cause one to think of his action in a daily life and realize that self-discipline should cause one to know that taking a part in worldly activities would lessen the respect of others have for you in position you hold in the church. The better your training, the greater the discipline, the better appearance your group makes, and the smoother your work will be.
Thank you, Brother Barry. We will have a selection by the Ervington Youth Ensemble.
Should I be discouraged? And why should the shadows come? And why should my heart feel lonely? And heaven and home, when Jesus is my cushion, my constant friend is me.
All right.
And I said, his eyes is on the sparrow. And I know he watches over me. I sing because I'm happy, because I'm happy. And I sing because I'm free, because I'm happy.
Sister Katisha Addison.
The title of my poem is Love, You Made Me What I Am. Mother, when I was a little child, you brought me to sleep. I couldn't feed myself. Mother, you taught me how to eat. You taught me about my clothes that I had to wear. You taught me how to talk and how to say my prayers. You taught me how to call you mother and how to call my dad. Out of all the friends and friends, you are the best friend I've had. I feel that I am dead to you. Your love was not a shame. The good things I am doing today, mother, you made me what I am. Mother, I have sympathy for you. You worked for me so hard upon bitter knees and shed a tear. You shed a tear and prayed for me to God. You taught me how to read the Bible and how to sing and pray. You sent me to search for a church I had to stay. Around the old fireplace, mother, you gave me this advice. Regards to God, be a follower of Jesus Christ. You taught me the Lord is my shepherd, and I am his little man. Now if I could only hold me, I would say, mother, you made me God.
Thank you, Sister Addison. At this point in our program, the ushers are going to have a memorial services for Deacon Frank Fields. He was one of the deacons here at Ervington Baptist Church, and he was also the head usher, I understand, at one time. At this time, we are asking the family members of Deacon Field to come forward.
Oh, speak for me when
give me all of my blessings. they may be seated if they wish, or they can stand if they wish. To the master of ceremony, which I didn't catch the brother's name. Hawkins. To Pastor Burson and pulpit company. To the deacon boards of the Ervington Baptist Church and the deacons that are assembled here today. Members and visitors and friends. And to a happy greeting to all the mothers that are still among us today and not the dead. We count it a blessing to be in the house of the Lord one more time. Somehow or another, Sister Barry finds most willingness to, on this particular Sunday, to find me free.
Well,
but you know, when it comes to working for the Lord, you're supposed to always be free.
Yes, amen.
Thank God I'm here again today to help you out on this 66th Usher's anniversary. Mm-hmm. A lot of things have happened, and a lot of things are still going on today.
Amen.
I'm up here not to bother your time nor your patience. I believe in doing what I'm going to do and sit down and do it within pleasing with God.
Amen.
I'm up here to conduct memorial service for Deacon Field. We can stand here and we can write a book about Deacon Field because he has been good to all of us. Today, I want to choose a particular subject to speak from today. It has been 3 years ago today that the late Deacon Field have passed this way. Well, the years have passed and gone, but our loves and the memory for Deacon Field still linger on in our minds and in our hearts. Today, let us focus our attention on how Deacon Field will describe his love towards and for God. In a loud voice saying, I can hear Deacon Field say these words, "Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thine heart and with all thy soul and with all thy might. Therefore thou shalt love the Lord thy God and keep his charge and his statute, his judgment, and his commandments." Deacon Fields contribute all of those aspects of life. "But he hath said in his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him, I will set him on high," says Deacon Fields, "because he has known my name." Deacon Fields loved the Lord thy God. When Deacon Field's name was written on high, when his name was called, he didn't fail to answer. A lot of us fail to answer when God calls. But we as children of God, we should never be ashamed nor fear the love of God. Deacon Field loved the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and all thy might. The Lord preserved all them that love him. But all that wicked will he destroy.
Amen.
"Lord, I love them that love me, and those that seek me early shall find me." Deacon Fields loved God, he loved all mankind. It was late in the evening when Deacon Fields answered to his call, but he found the Lord thy God. "But it is written, I had not seen, nor ear heard, neither have he entered unto the hearts of man, the things which God hath prepared for Deacon Fields that love him." All that Deacon Fields down here on this earth, on this earthly, all these toils and snares, the Lord preserve his work up on high and give him a home in heaven. "But if any man I shall say. But if any man love Deacon Fields, is also in love with God.
Mm-hmm.
If you love Deacon Fields, you couldn't help but love the Lord thy God. Deacon Fields was a loving and kind man, always willing to lend a helping hand. Here in our hearts, our love made perfect, that we may have boldness in the day of judgment. Because as he is, so are we in this world. There was no fear in Deacon Fields' love, because the perfect love cast out all the fear, because of fear had torment.
Yeah.
He that feareth is not made perfect in love. Love is pure. Love is real. But it say, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. Who shall believe shall not perish but have an everlasting life. God so loved the world. Deacon Field so loved the world. He loved his fellow man. He loved the Lord thy God. In my conclusion, I shall say to the Fields family that are still with us today, on this 66th Usher's anniversary, Mother's Day, and special love and memory to the late Deacon Field, God must have loved him very much. And we have still loved him too. We know how many helpful things that his hand has found for us to do. But still we reach, but until we reach that happy place where grief are all consoled, we'll never know the joy that Deacon Fields have found beyond the sunset goal of eternal life. Let us pray. Our gracious Heavenly Father, we come again in your holy and righteous name.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, O Lord, for what you have done in the years to pass.
Yes. Yes.
We thank you, O God, for what you are doing right now.
Yes.
Yes. Bless this family, O Lord. Bless the other waiting families that are in this congregation.
Yes.
Help them to realize, O Lord, they have a soul to be lost. One to be found. Jesus, bless our coming together. Let our coming together not be in vain. Help us to realize, oh Lord, that we must love everybody. Help us to understand, oh Lord, we must love them that hate us. Our blessing is reward is in heaven. You say it in your holy and righteous name. Man should always pray.
Yes,
and not faint. But Jesus, I stand here today in need of prayer. Thank you, Lord, what you have done for me right now.
Yes.
When I look back over my life, many things have happened down the way.
Yeah.
But you being such a good and understanding God, you know all our right from wrong.
Yeah.
But one day, we all must give account for what we do in life.
Yes.
We ask you, O Lord, that you will stand by us, guide us, and keep us.
Amen.
Showing us that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life.
Yes.
Then, my Father,
then
we have gone our last mile of
faith.
We can no longer serve you on this side.
Yes.
Would you please be so kind, so close?
Yeah.
If Job declared that we could cease from trouble, and all our souls would be at rest.
Yes,
these are men and blessings in your Son, Jesus' name. We pray. Amen.
Amen.
How I got over. Oh,
music by the Ervington Gospel Chorus, and we will do the scholarship offering in memory of Deacon Frank Fields while the choir is giving us some music. Deacon William Robinson, and I'm going to ask Deacon Mel Riley if he will fill in for me to take up this offering.
In your name,
I'm
scholarship fund in remembrance of Deacon Frank Fields.
Amen.
We thank the Ervington Gospel Chorus for the fine music that they give us.
Yes.
Now we are going to move on. At this time, we will have the history by Sister Barbara Addison.
About the Ervington Baptist Church, Usher Bowl. This Usher Bowl was set up in 1925 with a group of young girls and boys. They worked very faithful. Reverend N.A. Smith of Augusta, Georgia was called. He organized the Usher Bowl. The first chief was Sister Louise Canfield. The first clerk, Brother Frank Smith. Members on the Usher Bowl were Sister Louise Jackson, Sister Inez Green, Brother William Fields, Sister Harriet Holm, and Brother Hardy Williams. The young group worked well and very faithful. Sister Canfield served as chief for 1 year, then she moved away. Sister Anna Gill was chosen as our second chief. The Usher Board began to grow in spirit and strength by the young folks' wonderful work. This Usher Board bought some new items for the church. Some more members were added to the Usher Board. All of them were eager to work. Sister Gill served as chief for 4 years. At that time, she resigned in favor of someone younger. Brother Willie Jr. was chosen and elected as our third chief. At that time, labor was very cheap. This Usher Board paid $25 on the covering of the church top and $15 on the heater. This Usher Board then decided to join the Mount Hope Usher Union. This Usher Union was held at the Beulah Baptist Church in 1937. The delegates were Brother Frank Fields and Sister Mary Jane Jackson. Deacon Ben Wallace was the moderator. Brother Willard Jr. served as chief for 3 years, then he moved away. Deacon Frank Fields was chosen fourth chief in 1939. Sister Lizzie Allen was our secretary. She worked real faithful for many years. Sister Bertha Jackson was chosen mother of the Usher Board in 1939. The Usher Board paid $250 on the communion table for our church in 1979. In April 1987, the Usher Board bought 30 hymn books for the church. In 1991, the Ushers bought accessories for the ladies and men room. On September the 16th, 1988, one of our finest, Deacon Frank Field, died. He served as chief for 49 years. We are proud to have Sister Bertha Jackson as our mother of the Usher Board for 52 years, Sister Cora Berry as our chief for 5 years, Sister Barbara Addison, secretary. And we want to ask Sister Liz Allen to please stand up. She's one of the older members that used to serve on our Usher Board.
Sister
for that fine history of the ushers. At this time, we will have remarks by Sister Bertha Jackson.
And friends, I'm very happy to be here this morning and to serve the Usher Board for 50 years. And I'm happy because if I didn't have love and faith and hope and patience, I wouldn't have been here.
Amen.
Because
right,
if wherever you work, if you don't have love, you cannot make. I don't care what you work at. You got to have love. And if you don't have patience, you can't go nohow. Because love ain't no good if you ain't got patience. You start off and ain't got no patience, you just stop with what you do. So I'm happy to be here this morning and be a mother this Usher Board. And to graduate all the mothers. Because I had a mother once too, and she still lived with me. And I'm happy. And I want to say to all the ushers, not only one, if you're on the Usher Board, do your job.
My Lord.
And do it like it ought to be done. And always know your place in the church. And have more love. That's what we need, more love in the church. If we have more love in the church, we wouldn't have the ups and downs we have. Everybody would work together. We wouldn't have time to cut no prayers. And what I want to leave with the church and the members and the ushers, if I don't get back, always have love for one another.
Amen.
Fine remarks. At this time, we will have the church announcements by our secretary, Sister Ida Raleigh. We hope that you have enjoyed the program up to this point. Now comes the time for us to show our love for God. It's time for the tithe and the public offering. We're asking the financial officers to come forward, please, and everyone to participate in this, showing your love for Christ.
Amen.